You are getting ready to listen to the voice of Dr. Roddy Ferguson, 2004 Olympian, four-time national judo champion, Brazilian jiu-jitsu black belt, author, speaker, and coach.
Hey, what's going on, man? Good morning. This is Dr. Roddy Ferguson, 2004 Olympian, four-time national judo champion, Brazilian jiu-jitsu black belt, author, speaker, and coach. And I'm not in my home right now. I'm in my hotel room, and I had an opportunity this morning to get up with my cousin Greg. Greg is in the background. Lean on over, cousin Greg. And we got it in this morning, and we were able to, what's going on, Dr. Ingram? We were able to get up this morning and move around and walk 5 miles as we did yesterday. And we thank God for the activity of our limbs and the opportunity to move. And as we say in the in our fraternity in the seventh district, an opportunity to move and to groove. All right, and to do the things that we do. But today I want to talk about something that's really a situation that all of us deal with. It's Sunday, and my cousin Florence, his sister likes to call me a jackleg preacher. I'm not a jackleg preacher, but I do have a personal ministry, as I'm sure that everybody has a ministry on the inside of them that just has to come out because you have something to give. And anytime that you're sitting down with another person and you're speaking, you're actually having church service because wherever two or more are gathered. So there's something that happens spiritually through the connection because two are better than one because they have good reward for their labor. You just have to make sure that the labor that you're doing is actually good labor. Now, here's what I want to tell you. A lot of people have what we call the R. Kelly conundrum. People who know me know that I really, really enjoy R. Kelly. Not necessarily his music, not necessarily his behavior, but I enjoy his story, just like I enjoy David's story in the Bible, just like I enjoy Paul's story in the Bible. And David was the man who was after God's own heart. Now, because of the internet, we all form our opinions, we have memes, we have videos, we have news clips, and we're fed a certain thing, and then sometimes things aren't good to say because we have this culture of silencing. You can move around, Rufus, you can make noise. You in your room, you got a game to play today. You have a culture of silencing where people don't feel comfortable saying what it is that they need to say. I'll tell you right now, I enjoy the anthology of music that was provided by R. Kelly, just like some people enjoy the anthology of music that's been provided by Prince. You've watched Prince go from a point when he was highly sexual and ratchet all the way to a point where he, in his later years, Prince didn't even curse. So you have an opportunity to watch the anthology of people's movements, of their work. And a lot of people get caught up in one or two behaviors and don't understand that the thing that you can learn by looking at people are exemplars in life are not just the things that they do well, but the things that they don't do well too. If you go all the way back and you look at David, David has one of the you can actually call it a song, although it's a psalm. It is probably the most popular song in the world. It's the 23rd Psalms. All right, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. So when you think about David and you think about the things that David did, and David took a man's, David had this woman, he took her husband and put him on the front line to get killed so that he can marry the woman. This is what David did because he wanted to be with her. So he basically murdered somebody in order to be with someone. And David was a man after God's own heart, but David had his element of ratchetness that combined with righteousness. Now, nobody comes to the throne spotless, none of us. We all come with what I call the R. Kelly conundrum. We believe that we can fly, but we still want to feel on your booty. We want to step in the name of love, and we understand that heaven has to provide us with a hug, but when we see somebody, sometimes they just remind me of my Jeep because I want to ride. So you have to understand that those things that speak to your flesh, that speak to your person, that pull you through into a place are the things that they're magnetized into your flesh. And you have flesh. You make mistakes. So before you inject yourself with emotional steroid and get on Twitter and Facebook and text people and send out YouTube videos, just remember that you can be as righteous as you want to be, but you also have a part of raggedness to you too. You are raggedy in your righteousness. So you got to make sure that you're not so quick to point the finger at other people because you also make mistakes. So before you get on and pass along a meme or push towards an agenda, think about would I write this about myself on my page first and then make your movements? See, we all have a problem with exposure. If you go back to the Garden of Eden in the story, no matter if you believe it or you don't believe it, there was a point where the people within the garden, Adam and Eve, they realized that they were naked. And when they were when they realized, now understand this now, they had already been naked, all right? But they realized that they had been naked, and then they were what? Ashamed. So here's the thing. You're already walking around within your nakedness. You're already naked. You only become ashamed after you do something bad. Because you don't want to be exposed. None of us want to be exposed. So if you don't want to be exposed, stop exposing people. Well, Dr. Ferguson, some people need to be exposed. Yes, some people need to be exposed. Some people don't need for you to expose them. Some people need to be exposed, but just not by you. Before you go exposing people, ask yourself if you would want somebody to take one of your darkest secrets, one of the things that you're ashamed about, one of those things that you did because you didn't want anybody to know. Ask yourself if you would want somebody to know that. And if you don't want anybody to know that, then don't do that to somebody else either. See, the golden rule is superseded by the platinum rule. The golden rule is do unto others as you would have them do unto you. The platinum rule is do unto others as they want done to them. Understand that when you purport yourself as righteous, there's somebody out there that sees you as raggedy. And in your raggediness, which also encapsulates your righteousness, understand that you aren't always right, but that don't make you wrong. Because God can take people who are wrong and make them right. And I want to go all the way back to Keith Sweat. When you're operating in life and you're stepping in the name of love, understand what Keith Sweat said. He said, there's a right and a wrong way to love somebody. Y'all take care and have a super